All right, it is week one of level three East Coast Swing. We did one very long pattern, but we're going to start with breaking it up into two pieces. We're going to start with our throw out.
So, Lears, we're going to do a throw out. You're going to do a front back break. Back break. Raise your right arm. Lean, you're going triple step. Rotating, triple step. Rotating again to a back break. So allow the hand, allow it to go over for the triple step, allow it to get good distance from us. Rotate the left hand, triple step. As I follow her and go to the side, now I can rotate the hand over for this back break.
Followers, we're going to get this indication on our arm here that we want to bring the hand up. We're going to take that, we're going to straighten our arm, lead with the back of our hand for a triple step. We do not want to lean over and we don't want to crunch. We want to project over this right foot. We've got the arm coming through and we want to walk into this hand. Rotate. We want to walk into this hand but maintain this connection. So I can't let the shoulder go. I've got to maintain this, stay upright, maintain this connection. He's going to use this to rotate us around. Triple step. We're going to move off at a 45 degree angle depending on rotate again. Depending on your connection and your comfortability. See, I'm saying it now.
I'm saying it now, guys.
So depending on how comfortable you are and how strong you are in this arm, you may be able to move farther away, or you may want to keep it relatively close. What you don't want to do is let it go behind your body at all. It needs to stay outside of your hip line. So again, from this angle.
Back, break, triple step, back, break. Holding. So now we're going to do the throw out with a chicken walk. So we're going to go back, break, triple step, slow, slow, quick, 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 whoop-dee-doo, back.
So we have a little sailor shuffle there on the end. So we've walked away here in our throw out. Instead of doing a back break, we're going to come here for our first chicken walk. This is a slow. Leaders leading out on the same foot that you're stepping with. We're going to go slow, slow, quick, 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 quick. Hips rotating more than our upper body. Our frame has got to stay relatively stable. We want to make sure that we're moving. I don't want to bring my feet back and point. I'm going to point. I'm going to move on to that foot. I'm going to point with the next foot. I'm going to move on to it, and so on and so forth. The more comfortable you get, the further you'll be able to pitch back. To the point that if I let go, I would fall, right? So I'd like to be back here so that I'm really depending on him to pull me back. But for now, we can sit like this. The important thing is moving forward. Always moving forward.
We're doing two whoopies, curls are doing one. So slow, slow. Quick, 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 quick. I'm bringing the follower in as I go triple step, back, break. Making sure I come up with a two-hand connection.
So, leaders, it's very important to know, slow, quick, I'm here. You have to pull your follower into you as you do this swoop-dee-doo. She's coming into you, getting this two-hand connection. From there, we're both, we're both going to do swoop together side. So that's going to look like swoop together side. So it kind of has this kind of swaying motion to it. Swoop together side. A little bit different than the feel that we have for our triples. So it gives it kind of that different flair. So all the way through again.
Back, break, triple step, slow, slow, quick, 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 whoop-dee-doo, back, break.
And we'll work on that at the beginning of next week. Yep. Thank you.